Dear children, we are going to start the 100 dresses part 2. Till this, in part 1, you have seen the different people's opinion about Wanda. Now, this poem shares some more shades of Wanda's life. While the class was circling the room, the monitor from the principal's office brought Miss Mason a note. While all the children were taking round of this exhibition or this room, suddenly one PN from principal office brought a new circular for the teacher. Miss Mason read it several times and studied it thoughtfully for a while. Then she clapped her hands. Miss Mason read that circular one time, two time, many times, and then she became thoughtful. And then she made up her mind to discuss something with the children. That is why she collected, just to collect all the children, she clapped her hands. Attention class, everyone back to their seat. When the shuffling of feet had stopped and the room was still and quiet, Miss Mason said. Now Miss Mason collected the class, and when everybody became quiet, she said, I have a letter from Wanda's father that I want to read to you. Miss Mason stood there a moment and the silence in the room grew tense and expectant. Now Miss Mason became silent and the entire class became very quiet, seriously quiet, because Wanda was not coming and her father wrote a letter. So everybody were excited to know what was that. The teacher adjusted her glasses slowly and deliberately meaning knowingly. Her manner indicated that what was coming, this letter was Wanda's father, was a matter of great importance. She was going to disclose the letter with so much cautiousness that it seems whatever she was going to read had a great important thing. Everybody listened closely as Miss Mason read the brief note. When Miss Mason started the letter, everybody was listening it quietly. Dear teacher, my Wanda will not come to school anymore. Jack also. Now we move away to big city. No more Kohler Pollock. No more ask why funny name. Plenty of funny names in the big city. Yours truly, Jan Pentronsky. Her father wrote a letter that, dear teacher, my Wanda and my son Jack will not come to your school now because everybody, Holer Polak, because she had come from Poland. So everybody was teasing. Maybe to Wanda they were not teasing with this name. Her brother must be teased by that. And Pentronsky, the big name they had. So they were teased by others. So the father said, we are going to shift in big city, and in big city many strange names are there. Nobody would make fun of them. A deep silence met the reading of this letter. Miss Mason took off her glasses, blew on them and wiped them on her soft white handkerchief. Now everybody became very silent after listening this letter. Miss Mason cleaned her glasses and with her handkerchief, and she also became very serious and she was willing to say something to the children. Then she put them on again and looked at the class. When she spoke, her voice was very low. Now she had started addressing to the class. When she was addressing towards the class, her voice was very low. I'm sure that none of the boys and girls in room 13 would purposely and deliberately hurt anyone's feeling because his or her name happened to be a long, unfamiliar one. I prefer to think that what was said in thoughtlessness. Now she said that in my class, I believe nobody would have done it intentionally. Nobody would have hurt Wanda by teasing her long name. If anybody had done it, that is also done in thoughtless way, not serious way. I know that all of you feel the way I do, and this is a very unfortunate thing to have happened, unfortunate and sad both, and I want you all to think about it. She said it had it was a very unfortunate and sad thing whatever had happened. So I'm very meaning I'm thinking that you had not done it intentionally. This is for sure. The first period was a study period. Maddie tried to prepare her lessons, but she could not put her mind on her work. First, now the studies started. Maddie was trying to do her work, prepare her lesson, but her mind was somewhere else. She was unable to prepare her chapters, her lesson. She had a very sick feeling in the bottom of her stomach. True, she had not enjoyed listening to Peggy ask Wanda how many dresses she had in her closet, but she had said nothing. Maddie was feeling guilty. It was correct. Whenever Peggy was teasing Wanda, she was not enjoying it. But at the same time, it was also correct that she did not speak a single word of opposition. She did not oppose Peggy as well. She said she had stood by silently, and that was just as bad as what Peggy had done. Worse. Actually, her work was as bad as that Peggy had done. She did not raise her voice. She was a coward. At least Peggy had not considered they were being mean, but she, Maddie, had thought they were doing wrong. She could put herself in Wanda's shoes. Actually, for Peggy did not know whatever she was doing could hurt someone. Peggy was never poor. Peggy did not know, but Maddie knew it very well. Maddie knew because Maddie herself was very poor. So she was blaming herself. She was feeling guilty. Goodness, was not there anything she could do? If only she could tell Wanda she had not meant to hurt her feelings. She turned around and stole a glance at Peggy, but Peggy did not look up. Now, she was thinking so guilty. She was feeling so guilty that she wanted to do something. She wanted to accept her guilt in front of Wanda. She wanted to say sorry to her. She wanted to tell her that whatever was done, it was not intentionally. She made up her mind and she looked up towards Peggy. But that time, Peggy was not looking to her. She seemed to be studying hard. Well, whether Peggy felt badly or not, she, Maddie, had to do something. It seems that Peggy was lost in her lesson. But Maddie was sure maybe Peggy was not willing to do something in it, but definitely she wanted to do something. She had to find Wanda Petronsky. Maybe she had not yet moved away. Maybe Peggy would climb the heights with her and they would tell Wanda she had won the contest and that they thought she was smart and the 100 dresses were beautiful. Now she wanted to say sorry to Wanda. She wanted to convey this thing to Wanda that now everybody was praising her. Everybody was thinking that what a great person, wonderful artist she was. And she wanted to tell that all her 100 dresses were very beautiful. And she was thinking maybe Wanda had not gone. So she wanted to go her home. She wanted to say sorry to her. When school was dismissed in the afternoon, Peggy said with pretended cautiousness, "Hey, let's go and see if the kid has left town or not." Now when the school got over, so Peggy was also thinking for Wanda at that time when she was lost, seemed too lost in her studies. She said, let's go and see whether that kid has gone or not. She wanted to look very simple, ordinary, without having any feeling for Wanda. But it seems she was also feeling guilty. So Peggy had the same idea. Maddie glowed. Peg was really all right. Now Maddie was happy that whatever she was feeling, the same feeling was shared by her friend Peggy also, and she thought Peggy was really a very sincere, concerned girl. The two girls hurried out of the building, but the street towards Boggins Heights, the part of town that was such a forbidding air on this kind of a November afternoon, drizzly, damp and dismal. Now, both of them started going towards Boggins Heights, and that place was really looking very secluded, very dejected, out of any sort of richness